So, where can you find high-quality blog templates for WordPress? Starting a new WordPress blog is really exciting, but trying to nail down a great design, that can feel pretty overwhelming, especially if you aren't a web designer. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to one of the best resources where you can find professionally designed WordPress website templates and probably the largest collection of blog-specific website templates. This video is about blog templates, which are different from WordPress themes. WordPress themes can be a quick way of getting started, but if you want to make any design changes to your theme, you better know your HTML, CSS, and PHP code. However, with a blog template, you can effortlessly customize every aspect of your blog with a page builder like Elementor Pro. And if you're unfamiliar with page builders, they essentially serve as design software for creating WordPress websites. So let's learn about where you can find some awesome blog templates. And if you want to know what I think are the best looking blog templates, at the end of this video, I'll share with you where you can find the top 10 best blog templates for Elementor Pro. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and it's my mission to help you find the best and easiest ways of building high quality blogs and websites. I looked at so many templates when I was doing research for this video, and I came up with a few things that you should look for when you're deciding on which template or templates might be right for you to use on your blog. So what should you look for when you're choosing a blog template for WordPress? The main things you want to look for is, of course, the design. You want to look for a template whose design matches what you think looks good, as well as what fits the subject of your blog. Choosing a blog template isn't as important as choosing a WordPress theme, because first off, you can easily change the design yourself, and secondly, you can actually load multiple different templates onto your website and mix and match pages or even page section designs between multiple different templates. That being said, choosing a well-designed and well-thought-out template can save you a lot of time. The next thing you should look for after the design is the blog archive page design. And this is one of the most important pages on a blog. This is the page where your blog feed will show up, and it's probably going to be one of the most visited pages on your website. So it's important to pick a template that makes your blog archive page look clean and visually captivating. Look for templates with well-organized layouts and designs that match the theme of your blog. I would also look for templates that have sidebars where you can add links to other content on your blog and have space to place ads. Of course, you can always modify a template later to add a sidebar, but if you can find one with a good design, why not start there? The next thing you want to look for is the design of the single post page. This is the page that has the layout for your individual blog posts. It's important to have a design that's easy to read and navigate, as well as visually appealing. Look for templates with good typography, clear headings, and well-spaced out paragraphs. If your blog is visually driven and you plan to showcase numerous high-quality images, it's important to select a template designed to highlight your awesome images. On the other hand, if your blog isn't going to have a lot of images, look for templates that will look good with few pictures. This will make sure that your blog will look good in either case. The next thing you want to look for are web pages and page sections that you like. So pages like the home page, the About Us page, and it's important to remember that all of these pages are made up of different page sections strung together. So you really want to look for a template whose designer has thought of and built out for you a lot of different types of page sections. This will give you a great head start, and it'll save you a lot of time in building any page that you want to build on your website. Next thing you want to look for is mobile responsiveness. For many blogs, a large percentage of your visitors will be visiting your website from a mobile device. So you want to choose a template that is fully responsive and optimized for mobile viewing. Most designers are aware of this and have already made sure that their designs will look good no matter what device your visitors are using, but it's still a good idea to check. And another thing you want to check for is the number of required additional plugins. Many templates that I looked at require additional plugins to add design or styling options, and all of them used free plugins or free versions of paid plugins, so it's not really a cost issue. However, I think that in general, it's a good idea to start out with as few plugins as possible. This will keep your website running smoothly and minimize any potential conflicts. So in choosing a template, consider the number of required plugins and only choose those that are absolutely necessary for your blog's design and functionality. So where can you find high-quality blog templates for WordPress? There's a lot of resources for website templates for WordPress, but my favorite right now is Envato Elements. They offer one of the largest collections of blog templates for WordPress and Elementor Pro. Envato Elements is a subscription-based platform that gives you access to thousands of website templates. But the crazy thing about Envato Elements is that even though they have one of the largest collections of WordPress website templates, that's actually not their main focus. Their main focus is on providing design and creative resources for everything that you can imagine, from stock photos, graphics, stock videos, motion graphic templates, Photoshop templates, Lightroom presets, and so much more. And with all that Envato Elements has to offer, it can actually be difficult to find the Elementor Pro WordPress templates on their website. So I'll include a couple of links down below where you can find all of the Elementor Pro website templates, and also a link to where you can find just the website templates specifically for blogs. Using the links down below also helps to support this channel, so I thank you for your support. The fact that Envato Elements offers so many different resources for creatives is actually a huge benefit. Not only can you find high-quality blog templates, but you can also source other designs and creative elements to make your blog stand out even more. This means that not only can you find the perfect template for your WordPress blog, but you could also find stock photos to use on your blog, they offer great logo templates, and if you're a photographer, they have a huge library of Photoshop and Lightroom presets. And if you make videos, there's even more amazing resources for you out there, like music, sound effects, and motion graphics. When I was researching this video, I was actually initially only going to sign up for just 1 month, so that I could test and show you the Elementor Pro website templates. But to be honest, I got so hooked on the other creative resources that I decided that I needed the yearly subscription. Envato Elements is constantly updating their library with new resources, so you're never run out of options when it comes to designing or creating for your blog. So what are the downsides of Envato Elements? No service is perfect, and Envato Elements does have its drawbacks. One of the main downsides is that you can't purchase individual items or templates. It's a subscription-based service. This means that even if you only need one specific template, you still have to subscribe for a month or a year in order to access it. However, considering the wide range of resources available on Envato Elements, you might actually find that this service is a huge benefit to you. The other downside to Envato Elements is the licensing model. It's awesome that you have access to all of these resources, but there are some things that you need to keep in mind. And I'm not an expert on their licensing policy, so I'll include a link to it down below so you can take a look at it for yourself. But my understanding of how it works for website templates, and actually all of the other resources, is that you need to stay a subscriber for as long as you're working on the design or project that that resource uses. So for example, with a website template, you will need to complete the design of your website before you can cancel your subscription. Once you've finalized the design, however, you no longer need to stay subscribed, and you're free to continue using the website or whatever the final product is. The other thing that's a little bit confusing is that you need to register each item that you use to its corresponding project. So for example, this video clip here that I downloaded from Envato Elements, I needed to register it to this video. And if I wanted to use this video clip again in another project, I'd have to register it again to that new project. So you're free to use all of the available elements on as many projects as you want, but you need to make sure that you license each item to each project. And my understanding is that this actually helps out the individual creators for each item by allowing Envato to keep track of which items are actually being used and giving credit to the creators. So the registering process is a bit of a hassle, but I think it's worth it for all of the resources that Envato Elements gives you access to. So what's next? If you like the idea of using one of the Envato Elements blog templates, you might be overwhelmed by all of the options. And I actually went through and took a close look at each and every one of the blog templates that they offer on Envato Elements myself. The best looking and most complete ones I actually downloaded, installed, and tested. And yes, it took a really, really long time. But I can confidently say that there are a lot of great options. You can check out this video here, where I cover each of the templates in more detail and give you a better idea of which ones might be right for your particular needs. So be sure to check out that video next.